I wonder if you guys could hear that. First sound was my dog barking. I wonder if that was picked up. I think it was. Yeah, it was. I just double checked. It was. So, as always, I cooked the food, I used the bows, the amiibos. I don't know why I said it like that. And now let's sell them before we get started. No armors for me to sell. So I got a lot of stuff for me to talk about tonight. I highly doubt anyone's gonna tune in tonight, which is fine. I hope I didn't forget anything while setting up. I always get the feeling like I did. So it's October 25th. Just turned 10:04 p.m. I watched it turn on the clock, on the digital clock. I had to cook some apples because I was about to run out of space. So let me just first off by saying, you know, apologies for taking so long for doing this again. Sorry, I just got a Discord message. And I think that's it. So I still have space for apples, running out of space on meat soon. You know what's interesting about that? So what is this, part 66? Y'all saw that just now, right? 966 pieces of raw meat, and starting this, my Switch is currently charging at 66%, so there's a lot of 66s going on tonight. Okay, so I got a lot of stuff to talk about tonight, but first, let me just find my spot in the video, you know, the guide I keep using to see where the Koroks are. So yeah, took me, what, 8 days to do this again? Because I think the last time I did this was the 17th, I could be wrong. Do I have one on top of here? No, not there. Here, do I have the one on top? No, no I don't. Do I have the one here? No, I don't. So these are the ones I have stamped since last time. So let me see where I left off in terms of pinning their position. So I got this one. Got that one. Got this one. And then I got this one pinned or stamped, whatever. And then up next would be the one up here. Okay, so we know what we're doing. Yeah, I really don't think anyone's gonna tune in tonight. My dogs keep barking. I think everyone's busy, so no one's gonna watch tonight. It's fine. Wrong button. Okay. So like I keep saying, I got a lot of stuff to talk about tonight, so hopefully I remember all of it. I should have made a list of everything for me to talk about. Yeah, that's about it. I really should have. Ooh, two bugs. I only saw one. Don't be another flower trail, please. Oh, it's just a set of three trees. Damn, my dogs are going crazy tonight. My bogs. Okay, durian tree. So I need a. I already see which one I need to save. Just like that. Oh, a lizard too. It's hard to see things around here. What's up, man? Are you going to bed soon? Because it is late. Sorta. It's 10 p.m. So up next, should I just go back? Yeah, I think I should. I should just go back up and just go walk to the blue one. Just checking the feed. Seeing how it's playing. Probably around 11? Cool. Oh yeah, speaking of which, like you see it's raining in-game right now. It's actually been a rainy day in real life for me today. It's been gloomy, it's been cloudy and rainy all day. Like, such a overcast day the entire day. There was no business today because no one would come out on the weekday and when it's raining. Oh boys. My dogs are playing catch outside, so you hear them barking. It's gonna rain for most of the week. Oh man. That don't sound good for business, because people aren't gonna come out. Though less heavy after Thursday, that's good to know. Because tonight I'm doing this is a Monday. Wait, there's one more of you? So let's see, what's the first thing I want to talk about? Besides it being a rainy day. My dogs are going crazy. You guys can hear it. I know you guys can hear them. Especially if I stay silent. You can really hear them barking. Yeah, they go crazy when we play catch inside. Now, where's this Korok at? Please don't be on another flower trail. Well, no, it's one of those. I need one of these. So let me start by saying off some of the smaller stuff. So the reason I didn't play this for quite a while, I played this last week, is because, you know, also last week, a couple days ago, how many days ago has it been? Doesn't matter. So last week it was also my mom's birthday, so I had to, you know, do that. The rain makes it hard to see where this goes. So, you know, had dinner, had guests over for dinner, safely, of course. So, you know, that kind of prevented me from not only playing this game, but doing other stuff, recording other games, too. And then other stuff came up, etc. So, I'm playing this now. Where the hell does this thing go? Stupid rain, I really can't see. Nothing under there. Yo, I can't see where this thing goes. It can't go up there because it can't reach up there. Oh, I see it. I see it. The slight mist and fog helped me see where it went or where it does go. Right there. Yeah, right there. That was so hard for me to see. All right, which one of these two dick sculptures do I put this on? Probably the shorter one. So yeah, here I am playing this game again, a week later. Better late than never, I suppose. So, getting that small stuff out the way. Remember, I think it was either last time or two of these ago? I'm at 80,000 rupees, by the way. 363 Koroks. Not great progress, but progress nonetheless. But yeah, remember that a couple times ago, where I talked about the story of, you know, how I was essentially the supervillain of the story. You know, I was the criminal mastermind. I'm trying to think of other jokes to say, but I can't think of anything right now. But yeah, the story of how I was pinned as the bad guy for not selling or not agreeing with one of my friends' prices. Oh my god, a lot of people asking me this stuff. I'll bring up what people are asking me in just a moment. Yay, no rain. But yeah, also let me check the audio. I haven't checked the audio.
Or not agreeing.
There we go. Sounds fine to me. So yeah, that same guy who, you know, in his eyes, I was the supervillain of the story because I didn't want to sell him the lowest price possible. Yeah, that guy, that friend of mine, he dropped by the store just to visit with his girl. Like, he does that quite often. I don't know why he keeps visiting this raggedy-ass mall I work at, because there's honestly nothing to do in that mall, especially if you just keep on coming. So he paid me a visit, and he saw that I was wearing a lanyard with my name tag, with a name badge. Yeah. Yeah, that, I said that right. A name tag with a name badge. I was wearing a badge with my name on it there, with a lanyard. So he was like, yo, where'd you get that lanyard from? Because, you know, us students were supposed to wear one to show off that we are indeed students. This is the wrong spot. I don't need to be here. I need to be at that one. Words. So yeah, words, lol. So he asked me where I got it, because us students were supposed to wear one to actually show the customers that we're only students. We're, I spat everywhere. We're only students, you know, this is still not the right one. I need to be there. I think I'm supposed to put the rock there. So, we're supposed to wear a lanyard or anything with the name badge. The name badge? Yeah, I need to get closer. Anyway, so he asked me where I got it, and I was like, we have these. You know, and then I showed him. We have a whole bag full of them. He was like, do you have a black one? I'm like, yeah, I got a black one, because I wear a red one. Because you already know, that's my favorite color. Ooh, a chest. So I wear a red one. He asked for a black one. So he then asked me, yo, how much you want? Like, how much for this? And I'm like, man, we got so many of them and we never use them. Just take it. And then he low-key kind of started cheering. He started clapping like, that's what I like to hear. This is how it should be. You know, because I gave it to him for free. There's a lot of chests in this water. Hold on. So what do I do here if it's not the rock? And I'm... There's so many chests in here. Are you sure I'm not supposed to... Oh, it's a chain. Get out. So, the same dude who pinned me as the bad guy of the story because I didn't want to sell him shit for the wholesale price, he paid me a visit, a friendly visit. I gave him a freaking... Some sort of lanyard. Like, I don't even want to say necklace. Just something... I just gave him something, some sort of... Is it clothing? Whatever. Something to wear and display his badge for free. Like, I just gave it to him for free because we ain't using them. We don't need them. So I gave it to him for free, and then he started clapping his hands. He was like, that's how it's supposed to be. That's what I expect. I'm like, bruh. You asked me for the wholesale price last time. I gave you a lanyard for free just now. It's like, there's a big difference. The freaking cheapskate prick. Shock arrows, nice. Get out. Ooh, can just barely reach that one. Opal, why not? Alright, you get out. And this one. No, don't jump in. Come on, just there we go. But yeah, just a little fun little follow-up to that story. The fact that I gave him something for free and this dude had the nerve to be like, that's how it's supposed to be. That's what I expect. And then I was just like, you wanted me to sell you something for the wholesale price, something that is worth a couple hundred dollars. And then, you know, you start acting this way when I give you something simple for free. And you start being like, that's how it's supposed to be. That's what I expect. It's like, man. And don't let the way I'm describing this fool you. Like, he's not a bad guy at all. My voice just cracked. He's not a bad guy. It's just like, people can be cheapskates sometimes. Like me. Alright, so now we have these two. I should probably just fly down there. Get the green one first and then go for the yellow one. So how's everybody doing tonight? Excuse me. So let me say some things about what happened tonight. The day I'm doing this. Or, yeah, the night that I'm doing this, I should say. So earlier tonight, I actually went out for dinner. I went to the same boil place that I keep on going to. And they cook with a lot of oil, a lot of butter, very unhealthy. And a lot of garlic as well. So right now, my breath is hot. I got that stank-ass garlic breath right now. It's a good thing that you guys can't smell it. My screen might burn off. My screen might melt because of how hot my breath is currently. Shoo, it may stink that bad, it might be spraying out of your speakers. You may be able to smell it on your end. You know, all jokes aside, my breath does stink. Like, I got that atomic garlic breath. I know it's supposed to be on here somewhere. Oh, it's probably... It's a timer one, isn't it? No, it's a flower trail. It's right there. My dogs keep barking, and it kind of irks me. Well, nothing I can do about it. Well, too bad. You guys are going to watch this with dog barking ASMR in the background. I'm joking. I don't even think ASMR is the right term. So yeah, I ate a lot of butter and oil and a lot of unhealthy stuff tonight. So right beside me, I have a whole gallon of water. Because, you know, whenever I eat some very oily and unhealthy stuff, you know, I drink a lot of water, try to flush that stuff out of my system. Forest Dweller Bow, do I want to hold on to that? I have quick shots. I could probably get rid of this. Maybe. I could get this back anytime from my amiibo, so I can get rid of this. And just like that, I threw away a bowl of light into the waters of Farron. Any lucky soul who just happens to come by and swim and is able to pick that up. Well, you got a pretty divine weapon on your hands. But yeah, I have a lot of water beside me, and I intend to drink a lot more. Gotta love flower trails, am I right? At least I was able to spot this one. You know, at least this one was really close to where the end of the trail will be. Unlike other ones. So I came home. I also took a shower, cause I stunk, stunk, I stank, stunk. I stank of, garlic and a lot of butters and oil. Let's see, up next is the one at the very peak of this. Also because I wanted to wash my hair. So I see three more over here. There's one right around, a little lower than that, right around here. Then there's one, probably a floral ring here. Now, which one's next? Is it the one on here? Yeah, it is. I bet you this one's also a flower trail. So probably, what would be the quickest way? Is it to swim up the waterfall, or would it be to Revali's Gale here? Because I could get this one and then work my way around. Or I could do this one first, fly down, but not, but then I would have to climb back up with this. It doesn't look like that much of a climb anyways. Gee, I can't decide which path to take. I guess I'll just swim up the waterfall again. Hey, what's up, bro? I talked about the fact that I went out for dinner, had a very greasy meal, like extremely oily, cooked with a lot of butter. Because, it's a boil place. What they do is just throw a bunch of seafood into a plastic bag with seasoning and whatever, and they just boil it, or in a way, steam it, and then just serve it to you like that. Excuse me for just a second. So yeah, all the seasoning and flavor comes with the compound butter in a way, or just a stick of butter and then just a bunch of seasoning. What was it? Went to a restaurant that, went to a restaurant called Good Catch. It's a boil place. So, had boiled shrimp, mussels, clams, corn, sausage, all seasoned with the butter and some other spices and whatever. In fact, this time we got the Cajun flavor. So it was butter, Cajun flavor, and a bunch of seafood boils. Normally we get the butter and garlic flavor, but this time we got something different. Near the theater. So now all my veins and arteries are being clogged up by a whole bunch of butter. So just gotta, drink more water to try to flush that out. That might not be how it works, but whatever. Drinking more water is good anyways. And I do need to drink more water because it's getting cold out. It's almost November. It's getting cold. I do have a sore throat every time I wake up in the morning now. So need to drink more water. More water is good. Gotta love the temperature shifts. You've been there? It tastes good? Yeah, it does. It's not a bad place. It's just so unhealthy. Pricey though? Yeah, it is. It was what, $16 for fish and chips, which is also something we ordered and shared. It's next to a cafe, so we also got a fried rice, we got a club sandwich, we got chips and guac. So yeah, we shared all of that. My family of four, including me and a friend of my dad's. So, we all shared that. You know, it's one of those restaurants where you have to wear a plastic glove and eat with your hands. I only put the glove on one of my hands, so that way my other hand can use the utensil or grab other stuff without getting it dirty. Like if I want to check a message on my phone. So yeah, I only put the one glove on. Ooh, a flower trail, and one that I can spot! Get this done as soon as I can. The flower trails. Because I don't want to waste time trying to run around like, where is it? Where do I start? Yeah, you don't want to have oily hands? Sometimes you have no choice but to get your hands oily. Like for me, when I took the bag out, I guess it must have torn at some point because I had a little bit of oil and grease on my hands. I had to get up and go wash my hands in the at the bathroom. You know, my... Gotta take the shell off? Yeah. The mussels and clams. Shrimp, too. You know, my hand still smells like it right now. I even took a shower. I washed my hair, so... My hand should have more than enough chances to be washed and... removed of all the scents. But, guess not. I remember this one. I remember this Korok. This was a tough one. At least for me, so I'm gonna save right before I start. Excuse me, let me pour myself some water first. Gotta drink that water. Okay. So I need Cryonis. Make one more right there, a little bit closer. What game you gonna play after this? I have... Wait, hold on, let me make a jump! Ooh, that was close. Oh no, that one's not close enough, so I need to destroy that and bring it up. No! It's fine, we have plenty of chances, and I saved the game. So I have Persona 4 Golden. I haven't played that yet. A lot of people asking me to do that. I have Skyward Sword HD. I want to do that. Step a little further. Excuse me. Little bit more of a running start. And that hurt me too. I got Literature Club Plus. I haven't even opened that yet. I want to though. That's the initial plans for now. They may change. Let's see how long it takes me to actually finish this game, which I don't expect to be for quite a while, to be honest. Come on, come on, you can make this jump. No such luck. Alright, let me try a new plan. Man, I hated doing this Korok in the past. So, wait. Face as straight as you can. Damn, my Wi-Fi sucks right now. Oof. You gotta hate it when Wi-Fi sucks. You know, I actually lost Wi-Fi a couple days ago. Like, the internet in my place was completely out. Had to reset the router to fix it. Alright, so as close as three can get, and align yourself. Don't fall in and waste the rock. Align yourself, maybe, and throw it. Okay, okay, it stayed. Okay. Do I dare? Do I dare throw it and potentially miss, or do I jump in with it? As long as it goes in, doesn't matter if I go in. Oh boy, I'm gonna try throwing it. Center myself. Please? Ah! I should have jumped in. Now I gotta go over here and grab another. I'm running out of shots. I'm running out of basketballs to throw into the net. Okay, that works too. Wait a second. Let me put on some stealth to catch these fish. What did I just say? I tried to say it weird. That was on purpose too. Try to get some fish. So I went to a very smelly place. I say, what was that? Oh, electric keys. I mean smelly as in like, I am drenched in butter smell right now. Butter and garlic. Even after taking a shower. So I went to one of those places for dinner. I took a shower. And I forgot to mention this like a couple times now, but a few weeks ago, I think it was 2 weeks ago. So I was preparing for work. I was washing my hair. And then, you know, when I was finished with my shower, I was drying my hair. And then I felt something on my head. And then I've discovered there's a weird bump on my head. And it's really pronounced. There's like a rather big bump on my head. I didn't hit my head anytime soon. Not soon. Any recent times. I didn't hit my head recently there. So I have no idea what this bump on my head is. It feels like a pretty big bump as well. Now it could and most likely is nothing. It could just be the shape of my head. You know, not everyone's head is the same shape. You know, not every head is a perfectly smooth, round surface, like the round shape. You know, some heads just... Some heads have bumps and whatever. Is it cancer? Oh god, I hope not. So I have no idea what it is. There's just a weird bump on my head. A really big bump as well. You're here? Hey, what's up? So I have no idea what it is. It doesn't hurt. It doesn't feel mushy. Like if I press on it, it doesn't like lump in. It's solid. It's hard as well. It honestly might just be the shape of my head. So I don't know what it is. More than likely it's no concern. But just to be safe, I do want to get it checked out. Just to be safe. So as of me playing this right now, I have not gotten it checked yet. Up next is the one over here. I already got this one. And then one over here. I got that one too. Nope. Next one is over here. Over here, right around here. Right? Wait, is it this spot? Doesn't look the same. Oh, okay. Yeah, it is. It is this spot. And then there's one on top of Tuft Mountain over here. Oops. So I'll probably just go for the yellow one first. Bump on your head, RIP. Tumor? Oh god, I hope not. I really hope not. How many Koroks I got? The last I checked, I had 363, and I just got, what, 10? Give or take 10. Anyway, so yeah, I got this weird bump on my head. I don't know what it is. More than likely, it's nothing, but I still want to get it checked out. So as of me playing this, I have not gotten it checked out yet because, like I said, around 2 weeks ago, I discovered it, so I called the... Ooh, come on, come here. So I called the doctor, or I called the doctor clinic to try to book a schedule. And because it's pandemic times, restrictions makes it a lot harder. So I had to book like 2 weeks in advance. I also had to ask, like, is there any other doctors available that could check me out sooner? And the receptionist lady was like, no, because it's pandemic times, every doctor can only check out their own patients. You know, the family doctor can only check out that family's patients, the patients that they normally deal with. And also this doctor, some reason I can't remember, isn't always there. So I have to wait at least 2 weeks. I'm supposed to get a phone call at some point to describe the issue over phone. That way the doctor can have a little bit of heads up to what's going on. I have not gotten that yet, so hopefully I get it. You've had a bump for 2 weeks? Well, a bump that I've known of for 2 weeks. It could have been there a lot longer and I just didn't notice. So yeah, like I said, today is the 25th. I have the doctor's appointment booked for the 28th. And I discovered this like 2 weeks ago. So hopefully it's nothing. Cross your fingers for me that it's nothing. Hopefully it's just the shape of my head. Just covered up by my hair. Even if I go bald, I'm pretty sure it's not noticeable. Bruh, doctors have it so easy walking. Tell what's wrong, recommend another doctor. Or just write you up a random piece of prescription. Like, here, go to the pharmacy right next to us. Give us more money. So, should I just walk to the green one? Warp to this, go for the blue, and then walk over to the red? Probably. Need more water. So I'll just walk over to the green one. Ooh, a bug. Nope. You act surprised like it's him chatting. So yeah. I got a weird bump on my head. I don't know what it is, so I'm gonna get it checked out. At least here in Canada, like, it's free healthcare, so I don't have to pay for this. You know, if it turns out to be nothing, I don't have to be like, here, I don't have to receive like a $30 bill to get checked out for something that is nothing. You know, I waste the doctor and my own time, but still. I mean, yes, we don't have to pay taxes. The taxpayer money goes towards paying the doctors. So even though we don't pay, we don't pay medical bills, we do pay taxes or whatever. And that's arguably worse. Because we continue paying. Instead of just paying for each time we actually have to go. Anyway, so yeah, moving on from that topic. So I was talking about a bug earlier. So here's a quick little story. Yesterday, as of me playing this, yesterday was Sunday. So that's also another reason why I didn't do this yesterday. Yesterday was Sunday. It was Walking Dead night. More accurately, yesterday had Fear the Walking Dead and Roll Beyond. So I need to go over there. There's a Yiga here waiting for me too. I know, because I use this path to grind sometimes. Grind for what? Whatever small amount of rupees I can get out of that Yiga. Bro, I'm not going to say that line out loud. That Long Beach Griffey line, I ain't going to say that out loud. Yo, this ox super rammed into me. Look! Bruh! Yo! That was one atomic bull! Yo! I'm glad I got that on footage. Yo, that ox super rammed into me. Yo, that thing rammed into me. I flew into the next universe. That thing rammed into me. I went across dimensions. I flew to the past. Well, this isn't the Yiga I was thinking about. But I'll still take whatever rupees this thing will give me. I got 16 rupees out of that. Time to clip. Oh, I'm out of aerospace. And this dude's always being harassed by this Bokoblin. This Bokoblin. How did you not see me? I performed a sneak strike. Watch it happen again? I hope not. Electro Prime Meat Curry. I almost messed that up. Electro, you say? Like the Spider-Man villain? I went the wrong way. I super passed it. Let me head back. So I was talking about yesterday. So yesterday I was letting my dogs out. You know, I was opening the door to the backyard, let my dogs out for a pee, and BAM! Right on the door. A freaking centipede. At least the centipede was outside. Like, I opened the door and it was on the wall outside of the house. So at least there was that. It was outside. So I didn't need to bother it. I didn't need to kill it because it was already outside. Only issue is it was right next to the door. So I was too scared to enter the door. Because that means I had to walk past it. You know, what if this thing, like, when I opened the door, it charged in. It ran into the house. Or what if trying to walk past it, it jumps onto me? I don't know if centipedes jump. But yeah, there was a centipede right... Ooh, another bug I see. And another one. Yo, leave me alone. Ah, you scared away the bug. I'm gonna kill you for that. So yeah, there was a centipede right there. Right where the door was. Ah, you guys keep scaring away the insects. Put this armor on for a little more attack power. Another bug on the tree? No? Well, RIP to whatever this thing was. So, the centipede was outside, so I didn't need to bother it. I didn't need to kill it or anything. It was already outside. Excuse me. But, you know, poor little thing. It's getting cold out. You know, it's gonna snow soon. Hopefully soon. And, since that was yesterday night... Today, it's been raining all day, so who knows if that little thing survived. Nature is cruel. You know, that was an unintentional, somewhat transition, but speaking of nature, this doesn't really relate at all. But remember who knows how long ago I talked about the Marvel's What If episode, the one on the zombies, and how I was super breaking it down, like putting it down, how horrible the writing was for that episode. And not just that episode. Oops, there was a fly in here. Not just that episode, but the show entirely. But especially that episode. Remember when we came here to do this side quest? They're still here! You two gazing into each other's eyes for this long? But yeah, that What If Zombies episode, I was saying, like, there's no way the virus would spread through the entire Pacific Northeast within 2 weeks. Like, there's no way the whole world would be infected in 2 weeks. Especially if it's not like Walking Dead logic, you die and you come back regardless. Nah, this one, it has to be spread to be spread. But then I saw a video, I don't remember who it's by, but it was like, why you wouldn't survive the zombies in What If? So I saw that video, and, you know, he brings up a very good point, one that I considered, but didn't really think about, and that's the fact that in this context, in this story, these zombies, look, there's a heart shape right there, it's a heart-shaped rock pattern. But these zombies are intelligent. They still retain the knowledge of how to use their weapons. So you have zombies like Doctor Strange and Wong, who knows how to use portals. You have a zombie like Hank Pym, who can shrink and infect like he did with Cap. So what if they teamed up? I already got this extra hard Korok, pause. Dog's going crazy again. So what if they teamed up, you know? Doctor Strange could have opened a portal to wherever survivors are. And then, you know, mini Hank Pym, mini zombie Hank Pym, unseen, can attack people and spread that way. And then the dude in the video brings up a really good point. It's like, if Doctor Strange, the zombie version, can still use its portals, imagine the endgame portal scene, but hordes of zombies come out. Wherever you are, you're in a safe haven, you're in a safe location, and then, just out of nowhere, endgame portals, like endgame size portals open, and hordes of zombies come out. Yeah, you would be dead. You would be done for. And that kind of makes sense on how the virus spreads so fast. What are you saying in chat? Are you having instant noodle right now? Is that what you're doing? Is that what you're saying? Alright, let's see how many Koroks I got. 377. I am nowhere close to being done. Good God. I got 900 of these turds to get, and I'm only at, not even at 400. I'm not even halfway yet. I would obviously beat a horde of zombies. Yeah, no, you wouldn't. You would, a lot of people think they would. Oh, geez, don't stand on the fire. I'm not trying to put you down, I'm not trying to say you're weak. You know, people easily think, you know, they're dumb, they're weak, they move slowly. I could easily take on a horde of them, but in reality, no, you would not. Because once the numbers get up there, yeah, you're not going to survive that. Now, where is this Korok if it's up here somewhere? You're right, I don't think I know. So I just have to pick the fruit there. There's no tree that would grow apples and coconuts or palm fruit. Doggo! Got him. That just reminds me of whatever that TikTok thing was. It's like, what is Ligma? Ligma balls. Got him. Something like that. Okay, I can't climb these curtains. So, damn it, it's raining too. Do I gotta go up there or what? What do I gotta do? Can it not rain? Now there's double rain. I mean on the game's bottom right forecast, there's double rain. Oh, it's a flower trail, I see it. I see it, it's on top of the house, the boat of a house. Yo, can it not rain, please? Let me go in here. No, wait. Is there a fire somewhere, despite it raining? You want to see what I'm about to do? Instead of doing this, 20 or 40 rupees. Hell no, I'm not giving you that money. What I'm going to do instead, because it's free, it's a dangerous hazard, but it's free. Where is it? Ah, there it is. I'm gonna build a fire inside of this wooden establishment. This place made of wood. And I'm going to change the day. Just so I don't have to give you 20 rupees. This lady had to watch me build a fire inside of this wooden building. Just so I don't give her a red rupee. And it's raining again. Guess what, lady? I'm about to potentially cause another fire just because it's raining. At least the rain will help, I don't know, minimize the fire. How about night? Alright, no rain. I just hit my foot on the base of the table. Base? There's a flower growing on the side of a tree. Even though it's not an actual flower. Now where is it? There it is. So today I watched the trailer for Clifford the Big Red Dog. I know that trailer came out last week, but I finally watched it today. The only reason I watched it, well, I even remembered to watch it, is because I saw a YouTube ad, like a 30, not 30 second, like a 5 second ad of it, and it was BTS playing. And my sister is a big BTS fan, so I'm like, has she seen this yet? Let me look at the trailer and send it to her. And of course, she already knew about the trailer. She already knew it was playing. Because of course she does. So anyways, Clifford the Big Red Dog. CGI, you know, it's unfinished. You can definitely tell it looks like CGI. But it's still a trailer. Hopefully it's more polished by the time the actual film comes out. You're watching this in the future. That's how far in the past I am. Clifford the Big Red Dog, we're only getting trailers right now. The film isn't even out yet. BTS Army, indeed. But yeah, I watched the trailer, and what a surprise. My dogs are barking now. And what a surprise. Tony Hale is the villain in the story. Again! It's like, this guy only plays villainous roles. Can he not get a role where he's a good guy? It's like, god damn. Tony Hale can only play bad guys. Can I get a story where this guy does something good? And you know, it's like, what a surprise. A story about a giant red dog. Of course, scientists and the government want to capture it and study it. It's like, what a surprise. It's another story about government bad. Government ripping something away from a child for science and experiments. Like, how original. Okay, where is that Korok? Chess galore, and of course Kilton too. Look at this thing. I see what you just put in chat. This thing has wheels and an engine. It has an exhaust pipe too. It's like, where's the engine? Where's the motor on this thing? Alright, where the hell is this Korok? Should be around here. But, where is it? So regarding... Oh, is that it? My voice really cracked just now. Is it just that? No. No, it's not. I expect her- Ah! It's another flower trail. Where's motors? What? There's motors in Zelda? Yeah, kinda. We haven't gotten to that point in the game yet, but yes. Didn't know there was Industrial Revolution in Zelda. Then you haven't seen Skyward Sword. Or Twilight Princess. You know, something like the Spinner? Sure, Arbiter's Grounds is more medieval. But it doesn't mean there isn't technological advances. Kind of like in this game. The freaking Sheikah developed the Guardians. And we see in Age of Calamity just how technologically advanced Tarico is. And he was built as a toy by Zelda as a kid. Like a 7-year-old Zelda. She was able to build that. It's like, whatever, it's fictional fantasy. Science fiction, all that stuff. Time to bring... Wait a second. A 20 rupee? Didn't expect to see a 20 rupee in a big chest like that. But money is always good. So another story. You know, a lot of stuff happened. Before I forget again. So remember that thing about centipedes and all that? And how I'm a big coward when it comes to centipedes? And spiders? Oh, I just had 69 Koroks. Nice. Why do people always say nice when they see the number 69? Mr. Mosby, it's the law! So I got this one. I got the one there, way at the tip. There's one here. Next. Up here. Maybe it's up here. Maybe there's a cave in the mountain. I don't know. One over here. Right around. Oop, not there. Well, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter what I stamp it with as long as I know there's a Korok there. And that's it for the Koroks in this area. So we only got 3 more for this area. Where am I? Oh, I'm all the way down there. Let me get the yellow one first then. Where are the machine guns in Zelda? Would love to see Link pull up to Ganondorf, bring out 2 machine guns, kind of like Rambo or the Punisher, and just start firing, just start spraying. let hordes of bokoblins come in, and then it's like, eh, he just starts spraying. It's a law, you better read this properly. I already see you put a 68 there. Nice try. Oh, pfft. It's right there. It's right there. I was about to jump all the way down, and then I spotted it. It's right here. Nice try. You tried to what's the word? Hey, look, there's a bunch of bird eggs down here. I forgot this was here. You tried to humor yourself and the audience with my poor reading skills. You didn't think I would notice you put a 68 in that group of 69s, huh? But yeah, let me just tell this freaking story. So we all know I'm a big coward when it comes to centipedes and spiders. So, I think it was a couple nights ago, there was a centipede in the house. You better not ram into me this time. There was another centipede in the house, always, like, in the basement, as usual. What a surprise, it's in the basement. And obviously I'm a big coward. I ain't dealing with them shits. So I call my family. My sister and mom are in the living room watching TV. So I call on one of them to do it. And my sister's always so mad at me for having to get her to make her to get up and go take care of it. My family's always like, you worthless boy. You coward. It's a tiny little insect. What's there to be afraid about? Yeah, my family's pretty mad at me for always being a big-ass pussy when it comes to bugs. Look, I ain't gotta defend myself, but I'm still going to. Look, everyone's different. Everyone has their own fears, their own phobias. Everybody's different. I have an arachnophobia. What? An arachnophobia? Is that what it's called? I'm scared of spiders and centipedes, okay? And no amount of bravery or hair on my balls are gonna change that. You know, I'm not just gonna face my fears. I'm not just gonna let a spider crawl on my hand and be like, oh no, there's nothing bad about this. I'm not scared anymore. I'm cured. Like, that's not gonna happen. That happens for some. I don't expect it to happen for me. Like, there is nothing in this world that will change the way I feel about spiders and centipedes. I'm scared of them, and I ain't never dealing with them. Let's see if I can make this. Ooh, no, I can't. No, I can't! It still counted, though. Well, I don't even know if being hypnotized will make me not scared of them. You know, someone pull out a pocket watch and be like, you're about to get very sleepy. I fall asleep and it's like, when I snap my finger and you wake up, you will no longer be scared of spiders and centipedes. And wake up in 3, 2, 1. Snap fingers. I wake up and it's like, it worked. I'm cured. Thank you, Dr. P. Langton. I am cured. I can work at the Krusty Krab again. It's like, no, that's not going to happen. Tell me someone knows that reference. Oh god, please tell me someone knows what that is. Time to put toy spiders and toy centipedes close to you. You're gonna give me a heart attack and I'm going to die. Did I get those three? Yeah, I did. I got all three. Time to see the next set that I'm going to do. And there's a freaking ad. Thanks, YouTube. Unless I pay for YouTube Premium, I gotta sit through these ads. Ooh, a 10-second ad, huh? And it's only one of two. At least the second one's only 6 seconds. It's not an unskippable 15-second ad. Alright, up next is the Lake Tower. Excuse me. And this one has 90 seeds in this area. So who knows how many I've already gotten. There's a total of 6. On the bridge alone. Do I have this one at Daya Lake? Yeah, I do. The one right below it, no I don't. Right at this little C, the letter C. A very almost closed off letter C. Right around here. right on the very left of this waterfall. Oh, this is not easy. Kind of a somewhere out here. And right around here, this jelly bean looking lake. Probably not smart to go to the tower and fly down. Probably just gotta go here. I get that reference, not really, but it's a thought that counts. Dr. Peter Langton, specialist in Krabby Patty phobia. Or whatever it was. So let me mention something something else that was my initial plans for tonight, and then it changed. It changed pretty quick, too. So I've been playing Pokemon Let's Go Eevee. I hate that game, but I still got a shiny hunt in it. I don't got it, but I want to. I need more water, excuse me. Drinking all that water makes me have to pretty badly have to pee now. But I'm gonna finish this first. How long have I been going for? An hour and 7 minutes, that's okay. I can go on. I can keep going. So I've been playing Let's Go, and I've been shiny hunting the four legendaries in that. Pause the stream and go pee. No. So I already got Articuno and Zapdos. I'm pretty sure I mentioned that. I did both of those full odds because I thought hopefully if I just do this non-stop, I'll get it in a few days. Even if it takes me a week, I'll get it. So I got Articuno in 2 days. I got Zapdos in 3 days. I got Zapdos on the 9th of October. And now it is the 25th and I still don't have a shiny Moltres. It's like, for God's sake. I've been hunting this thing for 16 days now. Non-stop. And I have gotten nothing. Well, until today. I didn't get the Moltres, but I got something else. I'll explain how. So I hunted these things full odds because I was like, I ain't doing this thing. I ain't gonna play this awful game just to get the shiny charm. Like, no. No, I'll just endure the full odd hunts. You know, before anyone asked me, but why didn't you get the shiny charm? Because I hate this game. This game sucks. I don't want to play it, but I just want to shiny hunt the four legendaries and be done with this game. And you know, I got pretty lucky with Articuno and Zapdos, so I hoped that I would get lucky with the other two. Maybe it will take a little longer? Sure. A full week to do it? No problem. But here I am, over 2 weeks later, and still nothing. So I'm like, man, fuck this. I'm getting the damn shiny charm. Because this is ridiculous. 16 days doing this bullshit? It's like, man, I caved, and I finally got the shiny charm. Now, let me also mention. So I didn't do this alone. You know, the homie of mine, he helped me out with completing most of the decks, cause I told him, like, are you able to trade with me? So he took the time out of his own day to get most of the stuff that I needed, trade them to me. So that cut off a big portion of what I need. I see it. Oh, that's a bird. I thought that was the beginning of the flower trail. Oh, looky, looky, what we have here. It's another one of these metal blocks. Is that Rayquaza in the background? Yep, look at that. It's Rayquaza. Anyways, so yeah, my boy helped me out. He hooked me up with a good chunk of the decks that I needed. I needed like, what, 70 or 80 more to complete the decks? And because I hate this game, I'm like, yeah, I'm not doing that. But because he hooked me up with a good majority of what I needed, I only had, what, like 20 to 30 more to complete the decks? So today I was like, man, this hunt is ridiculous. I'm just gonna go out, get the rest of what I need, and get the shiny charm, and then continue this hunt. So that's exactly what I did. Today, I completed the decks, I got the shiny charm, and I'm ready to jump back in to hunting Moltres. Now, that wasn't my other plans, my initial plans for tonight. My other plans was, you know, I needed a Dragonair for my decks. And because it has a 1% chance spawn rate, and I tried to get that 1% spawn rate for like an hour, and I got nothing. So I'm like, you know what, next time I see a Dratini, which is like 4%, I'm gonna catch it, and I'm gonna level it up. I needed to level it up like 12 levels, and it lets go. The only way you can level up is either by catching or by battling. And I ain't battling. I'm not battling every or even one of the masterclass trainers or whatever they're called. Because if I do one, I gotta do them all. And I ain't touching them shits. Hell nah. So what I did, what I decided on, was I was going to catch to evolve or to level up. Is it gonna make it to that platform, please? Please? No, it's not. No, it's not. Shit. So what I decided, you know, because I had to catch random things to gain experience and level up, I figured, why not chain catch and shiny hunt something? Because that's how it works in this game. You catch 31 of something, and, you know, that increases your shiny odds. You cannot have something escape from the battle, or you cannot catch something else. You have to catch 31 of the same thing to increase your odds, and that's exactly what I did. So I caught 31 Nidorinos painstakingly to try to get a shiny Nidorino to try to evolve it to a shiny Nidoking. I got 31. I caught 31 of them. So that already increased my odds by a whole ton. So I was on my shiny Charizard. I flew overhead to be able to see anything that pops up. And I also used a lure. So that increased the spawn rates of rare Pokemon. So I was all ready. I was ready. I got 31 catch combos. You know, I got a lure going. I had a perfect spot to be able to see where everything spawns in. And I'm like, if I don't get a shiny for who knows how many hours, I'll just stream it. So essentially, I would have just sat there doing nothing, watching the screen in case any shiny appears. So maybe like 5-10 minutes pass. I look away for a split moment. I look back at my screen. A freaking shiny Fearow flies into me. And I encountered a shiny Fearow. You know, I didn't even have to move. It flew into me. It was the one that caused the encounter. I didn't even have to see the shiny and chase it down. Be like, no, come back here, shiny. Where are you going? Don't leave. No, that thing came to me. No pause on that. That thing flew towards me. So that was an automatic shiny encounter. So I'm like, God damn it, I'm about to cry right now. Do I catch this shiny or do I get rid of it? Do I sacrifice it to try to get a shiny Nidorino? What I was hunting. So I was like, do I sacrifice the shiny or do I catch it? You know, in a sense, the shiny chose me. So I'm like, ah, Frick, I'll catch it. So there goes my 31 chain of Nidorinos. So I got a shiny Fearow today. Trying to complete the decks, trying to get the shiny charm. I got a shiny Fearow today. And man, was I panicking. Because if that thing fled from the battle, not only would I have lost a shiny Fearow, I would have also lost my shiny, Well, yes, I lost a shiny. I would have lost a shiny, I would say. I caught it. I would have also... Alright, let me start over. If this thing fled from the battle, not only would I have lost the shiny Fearow, I would have also lost my chain, my catch combo. So I would have been all the way at the beginning. I would have gotten no shiny, and I would have to start from the beginning. So what I had to do was I had to, you know, use both Joy-Cons to get a little bit of extra help in that game. And I had to use a golden raspberry. And I caught it. So luckily, it wasn't what I wanted, but it was a shiny nonetheless. And I had to use a freaking gold raspberry. But whatever. I caught the shiny, and now I have the shiny charm. So I'm ready to get this fucking Moltres. After 16 days, once it turns midnight, it'll become day 17. Man, I've really grown to hate Moltres. Not as much as I hate Incineroar, but still. It's like, this is the second time in my life Moltres has caused me the most trouble out of the three legendary birds. Oh boy, where is this Korok? It's not just gonna... Oh, it is. I was just gonna be like, it's not just gonna be in the middle of the water. So, my initial plan tonight was to actually do that shiny hunt with the shiny chain. It would have been just me sitting there watching the screen until a shiny pops up. It wouldn't even be me resetting or doing anything. It would just be a plain screen, me doing nothing until a shiny pops up. And, you know, I got a shiny in like 10 minutes. I got super lucky because it ran into me. I didn't even have to, you know, chase it down, like I said. So yeah, I got a shiny Fearow today, trying to complete the decks. And in terms of completing the decks, yes, I got it done, but because I was playing Let's Go Eevee, I had some Pikachu exclusives that I couldn't get. I do have Let's Go Pikachu, but I'll be damned if I have to play this horrible game from the beginning just to get three version exclusives. And those exclusives being Growlithe, Gloom, or an Oddish. I needed a Gloom because I had already had Oddish and Vileplume registered. Excuse me. So what I needed was a Growlithe, Gloom, and what was the third one? And a Sandslash. And like I said, I'll be damned if I had to play this game again just to get those three. So I asked around on Discord, like, yo, anyone able to help me? Anyone actually have this freaking game? And luckily, a dude who can't drink milk helped me out on Discord. That sounds random, but I'm not kidding. That's his actual username. Because he said he's lactose. So his username revolves around that, the fact that he can't have milk. So he helped me out. He actually traded that to me while I was out at dinner eating all that oily food. You know, he said he had like a meeting for work in an hour or so. So I'm like, I'm just going to hotspot with my phone's data. And, you know, we'll trade then. R.I.P. Milk. Yeah. I can't even imagine not being able to eat cheese, because I love cheese. It's fattening, but goddamn is it good. Anyone here not like blue cheese? Because I do. I like blue cheese dip. My sister hates blue cheese. My mom's okay with it, but she prefers, you know, the the classic cheese that we all know. You know, the American cheese. Or an actual bar of cheese, like the cheddar, sharp cheddar. Or the Swiss cheese, mozzarella cheese. Like, she likes those more. Like, she will eat blue cheese. She just prefers the classic cheeses more. But me, I like it all. Why is there a well there? Is there something in here? I really need to pee right now, but I'm still gonna hold it in. That's not healthy. But what are you gonna do about it, hmm? You're gonna put in the comments, like, unsubscribe, unfollow if you don't pee right now. It's like, oh shit, let me go do that. Look at how big this tree is, too. Like, this log. Can we just take a moment and just look at this? Look, that was this. That's a hollowed out stump of a tree. And look at what we're walking down. The hollowed out log of a tree. This thing was enormous. Look, imagine how much lumber this thing would have produced. And there's a boulder here for some reason. No! Wait, wait, wait! Wait for me! You guys ever tried running in shallow water? It's not easy. You know, because the physics make it harder. Wait, wait, wait! Wait, yes, you stop there. Stop there. Gotcha! So yes, I am prepared to shiny hunt Moltres with my newly decked out shiny charm. I spent 16 gruesome days trying to hunt this thing. And I will not stop! Y'all hear? I will not stop until I get this Moltres. I'm not stopping. That's the determination of a shiny hunter. I don't care how long it takes. I will do it until I get it. Man, you can tell I have no life. If I spend my whole day freaking shiny hunting. Give me one moment, everyone. I don't know if you guys could hear that. I was getting knocks on the door. I don't even know if you guys can hear what was being said. Okay. Boulders. And a hole down there. We got three chances, so wouldn't hurt to save the game. Okay, this is heavy. Really heavy. Wow. Link doesn't normally struggle with heavy boulders like that. This man is a tank, and he can normally push things, you know, this size, this weight. Okay, two more. How long have I been going for now? An hour and 24. I do think I have to pause for a second and go pee. Okay, this one's an archery one. Okay, I am going to go pee for just a second. Excuse me for just a moment, everyone. I'm gonna mute so nothing gets picked up. Not like you can hear me pee anyways, just in case any banging sounds get picked up. Okay, I'm back. Play an ad? I don't have control over that. That knocking on the door earlier was me being told there's like a lemon water here for me. You know, well, lemon tea sort of thing. Really? There. So it's a lemon tea sort of thing. You know, lemon, acidic, whatever to cut all the oil that I consumed earlier tonight. You know, whatever the level of pH, you got acids and then you got bases. You know, they cancel out. Something with the acidity of citrus. I have no idea what the hell I'm saying. You know, it's like that iCarly scene of Spencer. He's like, "What? How'd it go again?" I think he said something along the lines of, "I may be an idiot, but I'm not stupid." You see, in a dumb person's mind like me, that actually makes sense. You may think that's a throwaway joke of a line, but that's it honestly makes sense to some level. It's like, I may be an idiot, I may be a dumbass, but I'm not stupid. Okay, I can't bomb this because I can't cut down a tree. And can't have you disturbing me. So which one is it? So I need to preserve that one. But yeah, that was a good pee. Very satisfying pee. My bladder is empty now. You know? Less stress. Whatever. I wonder if anyone's gonna comment this. Well, no one's going to now. Maybe you already did, and I'm addressing it now. You know, I don't know if anyone's gonna be like, "That was really quick. Did you wash your hands?" Me taking this long to answer will immediately make people think the answer is no. But let me explain before you jump conclusions. So this is weird of me. Like, I'm a weird guy, let's be honest. I'm weird as fuck, and that's just who I am. So this is the case for me. People are gonna clown on me for this, I know it. But this is just me. There's two Koroks right here, by the way. So this is what I do at home. So when I'm at home, I pee sitting down. I know nobody wants to hear that. Nobody cares. But that's just me, okay? When I'm at home, I pee sitting down. Hold up, many questions. Yep, you see? You're already jumping to conclusions. Conclusions? Is that what I just said? Now, just because I pee sitting down doesn't mean I don't wash my hands. But also doesn't mean like I scrub and completely lather with soap. So I pee sitting down and I lightly rinse my hands. I know that doesn't really help. Like, that's not getting rid of any bacteria. No. don't worry, it's 2021. No one washes their hands anymore. But yeah, I know people are gonna clown on me for that, like this guy pees sitting down. What a loser. How unmanly. Look, okay, I don't pee sitting down when I'm in public. That's nasty. Unless I really have to go poop, unless I have to really take a dump, I ain't sitting down out in public. Now the reason I do it at home, obviously because I'm at home and it's cleaner. See, there's two Koroks right here. But the reason I sit down to pee at home, aside from it being sanitary, is because I don't want to make a mess. You know what I mean? It's like, fellas, all my men watching out there, you guys know sometimes we make a mess. Sometimes we unintentionally make a mess, and because it's home, we gotta clean it up. When I sit down, there's less to no chance of me making a mess. All I gotta do is sit down, and when I'm done, I flush. And then I lightly rinse my hands. So, you know, I pee sitting down when I'm at home. I know so many people are gonna clown on me for that. A lot of people are gonna be like, this guy's so wimpy. He's not a man. He doesn't pee standing up. It's like, who the hell cares? Look, it's my life, my home. I can do it how I'd please. It works, doesn't it? Does it not work? You know, I'm getting rid of the urine in my bladder, and it goes into the toilet, and it gets flushed away. Does it matter how it goes in? So where does this go? Okay, it goes into the one on the wall. So yeah, that's why it took so quick. What is that back there next to the well? What is that? Looks like a snail. Why would a snail be over there? Oh no, it's a weapon. I thought that was a snail. Do I take them down? There's a lot of them. Sure, why not? You die! You die! You die as well, I said! Damn, you guys are weak! A single guy annihilated your group in what? 30 seconds? A minute? Aw, there goes a lizard. So I could probably just... Nah, that's... I can't go to that shrine. It's inside. So I have to make it here by myself. Unless I go to that shrine and I... Nah, it's probably faster if I just walk there myself. But is it actually unmanly of me to pee sitting down at home? That's a weird question. But I'm asking it nonetheless. Let me get the Shao Kahn skull cowl off my head. Let's see if anyone knows who I'm talking about. I'm betting I'm probably forgetting to talk about something tonight. And back on the Sheikah armor I do. What? Back on the armor I do? Yep, I really said that. So in the off chance... Oh look, the two Koroks, right here. So the off chance I actually do manage to get Moltres before I get a chance to stream it again, I'll just do Mewtwo next. It'll be super satisfying, me getting Moltres on stream. Like after who knows how long, over 2 weeks, reaching the 3 week point for me to get it and get my reaction. I did say, excuse me, let me drink this lemon tea I got next to me. It has honey in it too. Good for the throat. I did say that once I get all four legendaries shiny in Let's Go, I will be done with this game. Maybe I will do shiny Nidoking just because. You know, I couldn't get it today, just because I couldn't do that. Let me get that, and then I'll be done with this game. Alright, so this is like one of those unique Koroks. Four rocks in every corner, except that corner, and the rocks up there. I'm sure you can put two and two together, what needs to be done here. Yeah, but you have a very tight spot. If I remember correctly, whoa, Link just ran into the camera. Let me save the game just in case I mess this up. So let's see. Bomb arrow. Stasis. Oh yeah, that was just enough. If you're lucky, you can actually shoot it and it will go right on the spot it needs to. I need to walk a little more this direction. Hopefully it flings it. There we go, perfect. Imagine an ordinary inhabitant of Hyrule actually manages to solve one of these puzzles. Like, there's 900 of them. It's not hard to believe that one person somewhere solved one of these puzzles. You know, putting aside the whole thing, like, in lore-wise, like, the reason Link can do this, like, only people of pure of heart can see the Koroks, and Link is one of them. You know, people pure of hearts, like children. So, like, ignoring that, if someone out there actually was able to solve one of these puzzles, then Link would be kind of screwed. Because he wouldn't be able to get all 900. He would get, like, 899 and wonder who took that last one. So I got this one. I don't have the one here. Nor the one here. I don't know how much longer I'm going to go for. Maybe just a few more. Or maybe just this last set of five. You know, I just reminded myself, speaking of the number 5. So, right around here. Speaking of the number 5, remember the McDonald's toys I bought? How I mentioned one of them was the Battle Force 5 set? Well, like I said, there was a... I bought the 2010 set. I didn't buy the 2011 set just yet. And then, you know, while looking stuff up, I discovered there's another set. There's a third set. It looks pretty awful. Like, it looks like it's way worse quality. But still, I want them nonetheless. From, like, the quick 10-minute research that I did, I've learned that it was, like, 2013 in Argentina, I think. There's no listings for it on eBay. Obviously, Amazon doesn't have anything. I don't want to look at Etsy or Kijiji. So, I know this is not a smart idea, but I'm desperate. I want these toys. So I was like, if anyone in the future watching this can help me find them and not actually scam me, like actually hook me up with an affordable deal to get my hands on these what appears to be 2013 Argentina Battle Force 5 McDonald's toys, then please comment down below. Like, if anyone out there can actually help me out with this, please, please do help me. I'll mention this in the beginning of the next video too, just because I doubt any soul on this planet will actually make it this far into the video. So I need to make a note for myself. In the beginning of the next one, I'll mention that. So it's right at the beginning. So anyone clicking on will be able to hear it. And hopefully someone out there can help me with this, because I can't find it anywhere. And yes, I'm playing a dangerous game here right now. Not the bombs. Like asking people, like having faith enough to ask people like this for help. But it's like, what else can I do? Weird angle there, Korok, but okay. I've been doing this for an hour and 44. Minus what, the 2 minutes I took to go take a piss? But yeah, all these years, I thought there were only two McDonald's sets of this show. Like, two McDonald's toy sets of this show, this awesome show. And then I come to find out there was a third. This whole time, there was a third set that I never knew about. And the reason I never knew about it was because it wasn't in my country. So, of course I want them. I saw a video review on them and they look pretty terrible. They look pretty poorly made. Way less quality than the first two sets. But it's like, I still want them. Are the rocks all the way up there? Oh no, they're there. So it's like, if anyone can actually help me out with this, that'd be greatly appreciated. Buy them all? I would if I can find them to buy. But yeah, I saw the review, a review video on them, and they look pretty poorly made. Pretty way lower quality than the first two sets were. But it's like, they're still official McDonald's toys of a show that I love very dearly. So it's like, yes, I want them. I want them very much. I probably should have saved the game before I did that. Push the boulder down. And look at this, we got a unique one here. We got to push this uphill. Don't want to launch it too far now. Also don't want to overdo it. Oh look, it didn't roll back down. Lucky me. So I just need to tap this lightly into the hole. Please? Yes! My Master Sword is running out of energy, so I'm gonna... So before I go do these two, which I'm gonna warp to the tower for, I'm gonna go charge up my sword, and then I'll go do them. That's good, I can also see what Hestu can offer me. It's 11:49 PM right now, so it's almost midnight. Almost about to turn day 17 of hunting Moltres. I'm sure by the time you watch this in the future, I would have long gotten it by now. Like this was a shiny hunt drought of mine for a long time. Like by the time you watch this, this was a shiny hunt drought years ago. But for me right now, I still haven't gotten it yet. By the time you watch this, I probably have. I more than likely have. In fact, you watching this right now in the future, I do indeed have it. Wait, which one am I upgrading? Yeah, sure. Bow it is. 25. I got 25 Koroks just to upgrade this bow slot. And yeah, that's the last bow slot. Before people who don't play this game be like, wait a second, you said last bow slot, but there's clearly one left. Yeah, this game is kind of stupid that way, where it only gives you all but one. It on purposely does not give you one extra bow slot, which I find absolutely stupid. We'll find out why in the finale, but who knows how long that'll be. Because we still got Koroks. We still got map locations, assuming I don't do them all while getting Koroks. We still got the DLC. We are nowhere done, nowhere near done this game. Another 15. So I can't do any more upgrades because he's asking me for minimum 15. Assuming he asked me for 15 for the last three. 15, 30, 45. So I need minimum 45 for the next upgrade. Alright, save the game before it crashes here. Damn, it feels good to be playing this game again. You know what I mean? It's like, been over a week since I last played this. Damn, it feels good to play this game again. You guys remember how there's a sequel to this game coming out next year? Y'all remember that? And y'all notice how I'm still nowhere near done this freaking game? Like, nowhere near done? My boy actually told me, like... I actually told him, like, I am still nowhere near done this game. I got 900 Koroks to collect, and I'm not even halfway done. And then he told me, like, that's because you're doing absolutely everything like a maniac. And then I had to remind him, like, keep in mind, I did all this twice already. I beat this game 100%, 900 Koroks included, two times in the past. Did it on my first file of this game, and I did it on Master Mode. You guys actually saw those game files, those playthrough, whatever. You guys actually saw those. 404 Koroks. So we're just shy of being done. No, not being done. Being halfway done. Hell no, we are not shy of being done. So we're almost halfway. What's, halfway is 450. We got 404. So that means we need 46 more to be halfway done. Can you guys believe it? We're almost there. We're almost halfway done. After all this time, halfway done. Not even 3/4 or 90% done. After all this time, only halfway done. Something, what, Gucci? Plain barrels? Did that say Gucci? Is it up here? If not, it's underneath that, that stone. Stone? S-D-O-N-E? Stone? That stone plank. Stone. No, it's not up here. No, not bomb arrows. Do I have my sword equipped? Yo, Yeeg. Yo, Yeega, you wanna come down here? Yo, Yeeg, come taste my blade for a second. Ooh, I see red rupees. 45 rupees I just got from him. Master Koga must pay these guys good. If they just have Korok, not Korok, they just have rupees to drop. Is that half buried? That chest is half in the ground. Never seen that before. Alright, the Korok's definitely supposed to be up there. I think it's another timed one. I was about to be like, should I shoot it? But nah, that would just get rid of the bush on top. That would just waste an arrow. So if I'm guessing right, I have to climb up there and race over to that one. Damn, you Octoroks are annoying. I love how whenever Octoroks, especially Octoroks, die, they just clip into the world. Like, they always do that, and it's only Octoroks. Is it up here? Yeah, it is. I knew it. Gotta hurry, gotta go fast. Remember that meme? Come on, gotta go fast. Oh yeah, something else I forgot to talk about. So I saw on Twitter by Amiibo Alerts that Nintendo Wire, they posted a tweet of a rumored Bronze Mario Amiibo. The silver one came out, what, 2015? 6 years ago? By the time you're watching this, probably 10 years ago, 15 years ago, I don't know. Like, for me, the silver Mario came out, what, 6 years ago? So I was like, why would they make a bronze one now? I mean, I'll still buy it if they make it, of course. There was nothing under here. Like, I have two gold Mario amiibos, and I have one silver. I should have two, but I was an idiot and didn't buy the second silver amiibo. Let's see. I've been going on for 1 hour and 57. Maybe I'll do five more and then I'll call it there. So next one up here, I have this one, but not this one. Okay, I think this is the one I was thinking about. Like last time I was saying, like, I know what this Korok is. Somewhere inside of Farron, and then I was like, nope, wrong one. I was thinking of a different one. I think that's the one I was thinking about. So yeah, they produce a bronze Mario amiibo. I'll pick it up. Even though it's just a regular one spray painted bronze. At this point, they may as well just do if the bronze one is real, I should say. If it is real, at this point they should just, release like a rainbow of Mario amiibos. If they release a shiny chrome like red one, boy, I'd be buying that one. I'd buy two to display. 'Cause I do love me some red color. Like, you know me, I got my five favorite colors. If they release a red, green, blue, and purple, like I would display that with my gold, and I got all five of my favorite colors in Mario amiibo form, and it's like, yes, you do that and I will pay for it. I will somewhat happily pay for it. It's a flower trail. Flower trail. There it is. You know, my amiibo's a little. My amiibo collection's a little unique to anyone else's. At least I think so. Like, I'm gonna have five Game and Watch amiibos in my collection, one for each pose, and then one that's just the base. One that doesn't have a character on top. Same goes for each Monster Hunter. And then, my collection, one day when it's complete, is gonna have other stuff too. It's gonna have quote unquote official release stuff that function like an amiibo, but isn't one, like the power save N2 Elite or the no, it is the power save or the N2 Elite. It's gonna have hopefully those two in it. I already have the power save, but the N2 Elite is hard to find. Like, those are quote official released by a third party company, so they're somewhat official release, but they're not amiibos. They function like them, but they're not amiibos. So I'm gonna have those in the collection. It's stupid, but hey, it's my collection. Like, I'm only collecting the official release stuff. I'm not gonna include, like fan-made amiibo chips or NFC little tags sold on eBay. It's like, yeah, those function as them, but those aren't official release, so I'm not including them. All right, here's the unique Korok right here. So this chain ball right here, you have to get this one. Oops, not this one. Yeah, this one here's the example. You have to get that chain ball in the water onto that platform. And it's not easy because it'll roll off, so you have to make it stay on. So what I do, oh boy. I already messed this up. How far away am I? Okay, did that autosave save before or after I got this? Let me save here. So I have 16 in my bag. So if I come here, do I still have 16? That was weird. The top corner took a while to load. Yes, I do. Okay. I kind of messed that up. Let me try again. So yeah, what you need to do is you gotta get both of the metal balls on that chain. You gotta get each of them on top of one of these platforms. So what I do is first I stasis this, and then you gotta move quick. Try to get this on here. That's not working. But yeah, you see, it stays. So anyways, as I was saying. So, yeah, and my Amiibo collection is going to hold official release stuff. Official release stuff that function like an Amiibo. But it kind of goes, at least in my collection, it kind of goes both ways too. Like, not only will my collection feature things that work as an Amiibo, but things that resemble it, but don't scan like an Amiibo. And what do I mean by that? Some Amiibo display stuff, not all, but some, kind of like the Amiibo warp pipe. It's stupid, okay? It's stupid, but my collection. There's also a display case. I'm not gonna collect everything, but you get the idea. And it's not even like display stuff either. Stuff that holds the figures. I'm talking about, you know, like I said, my collection extends both ways. Some that function like an Amiibo but aren't. And some that resemble an Amiibo but don't scan, don't function like one. They resemble but they don't function. Kind of like the giant Mario Amiibo that don't actually scan from like NYC, the New York store, the New York Nintendo store. Like if only I could steal, I mean procure one of those, like I would put that in my collection, a giant Mario Amiibo that doesn't scan. If I could get my hands on that, of course I would put it in my collection. But yeah, that's just how I'm gonna handle my collection. So what am I doing? I need to go this way. Buy it? How recent ago did you say that? Whoa! I don't think I get fire arrows if I kill you. I don't even know if I can buy the giant Mario Amiibo statue. And if I can, it'd go for like what? Minimum $1,000? Which I'm not wasting that money. Maybe one day if I'm like Elon Musk rich, then I would. But right now, I'm not gonna waste my money on a giant statue I don't need. I would like, but I don't need. Alright, I'm getting these last two Koroks, and then that's gonna be it for tonight. Let me get this chest first, see what's in it. No! I almost pushed it off of this icy surface. Amber, okay. Is anyone watching named Amber? Maybe in the future? Comment down below if that's the case. And a ruby. Is anyone named Ruby watching this too? Also comment below if your name is Ruby and you're watching this in the future. So there's one Korok here and another right there. Think it needs a little bit of help. I spat all over my screen just now. There we go. Alright, it's 12:11 a.m. I've been on for over an hour. I'm gonna get off soon. So I'm just gonna, once again, stamp the next 5. And then I'll continue next time. So there is one right next to the shrine, and I mean right next to it, around here. One right around where the W on the woods is. No, not there, not on the W, right below the woods, the word woods. Right in between here. Right on top of here, which I bet you is going to be a race. Never mind. I thought it was going to be a race from here to here. Still might be a flower trail, though. And then... Oh, I already got that one. So there's a set of 3 here, but I don't have this one. Let me just take a close look exactly where this is for next time. Right around here. That little spot. Alright. We got our next 5 for next time. Excuse me. Got some greasy, oily, buttery burp just now. That's nasty. Drink more water. Four hundred ten Koroks. And I had, what, 363 when I started? So how many is that? Pull out the calculator. 410 minus 363. 47 Koroks tonight, I think. Unless I got some before I counted, before I saw it said 363. So maybe I got more tonight. So roughly around 47, minimum 47. Gonna link let rest, because he's been out there hunting Koroks for days now. That took a long time to load. Oh, it's raining. Nope. Back inside I go. Gonna sleep until it's not raining, that way I can use the fire to cook. Oh, it's still raining. Back to bed Link goes. Pfft. Wow, Link is getting some good sleep. What do you take, Tylenol? Not Tylenol. That's what I get for that awful reference, or whatever. I was about to say NyQuil, not Tylenol. I meant to say NyQuil. You ruined it. Alright, now it's not. So I'm gonna save right here in front of these two dudes. So let's see, what do I have to cook? I need to cook probably some apples to make room. Some of these, but mostly this. Do I have room for shrooms? Little bit more. I should probably cook some of these too. So yeah, our numbers are getting up there. Matter of fact, you don't really get a good look at what the numbers are now. You can compare them with the previous numbers, like before and after each amiibo use. So there you go. These are the numbers as I have them now. You can compare them next time when I use my amiibos. Well, that's gonna be it for tonight. I'll see you next time.